10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Ignition. And lift off.
M1D propulsion is nominal.
T plus 40 seconds since the launch of Falcon 9. Propulsion is confirmed. Merlin's lift nominal. Power and telemetry are confirmed nominal from the avionics engineer. We're throttling down right now on the Merlin 1D engines. Preparing for supersonic and max Q.
Knock one.
Got the call out for Mach 1. We have throttled the Merlins back up to full power. Next event will be maximum dynamic pressure. And there we are. We're going through the thickest portion of the atmosphere at the highest speeds. Now, as we continue to accelerate Falcon 9, the air density gets thinner and the loads on the vehicle decrease. A minute 30 seconds, trajectory continues to look good.
Back
D chill indicates we're now beginning to bleed a little bit of liquid oxygen through the upper stage engine turbo pump to get it ready for ignition coming up in just about 40 seconds from now. Nice view from the ground camera looking up the long plume coming out of the 9 Merlin 1D engines. Now, major event coming up will be main engine cutoff coming up at just after 2.5 minutes called MECO. We shut off all the 9 engines. We'll separate the first stage from the second stage, and we will ignite the second stage engine called SES-1, the second stage engine start number 1. Beginning to throttle down.
MECO.
Stage separation confirmed.
And we've got successful MVAC full power ignition. The view on the right shows the MVAC engine, the second stage now taking over, carrying the Starlink and BlackSky satellites to orbit. On the left screen, the first stage is continuing without power to coast to apogee, and you can see the large titanium grid fins beginning to open with the lights of the United States in the background as we slowly head up the eastern coast of America. There's a view of the fairing, and we confirm fairing separation.
Stage 1 entry burn startup.
Heard confirmation of the stage 1 entry burn startup. You can see those backlit grid fins with those 3 engines burning there. Again, this burn lasts 20 seconds.
Stage 1 entry burn shutdown.
We've had confirmation of successful stage 1 entry burn, and we're about a minute away from our landing burn. The landing burn will start at T plus 8 minutes, and it is also about 20 seconds long.
Continue following normal trajectories.
Stage 1 landing burn.
Heard the call out for the start of stage 1 landing burn. You can see the clouds sort of lighting up there.
Start internal guidance.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
Wow, look at that stage 1 sitting on our drone ship. Of course, I still love you. That was a beautiful view of the stage 1 as it came down there, lighting the clouds up. And in just about 10 seconds here, we'll have second engine cut off there right on your screen.
Global 7, deploy confirmed.
We've heard confirmation from the avionics engineer that Global 7, the first of the two BlackSky satellites, has successfully deployed. We're waiting to see if it might come into the field of view of the camera. This camera is mounted on what we call the payload attach fitting. It's a somewhat conical structure on the front of the second stage, and that's what the Starlink satellites are mounted on top of. That's the stack of satellites you see in the picture. And then at the very top are the two BlackSky satellites. And I think we're starting to get a view there. And right into the sunshine, or a sun glare. Not sure yet if that's a reflection or, but I think we got a short view of it there, and then it's overpowered the field of view a little bit. Camera's still working though, so that's good.
Global 8 deploy confirmed.
And there it is, Global 8 deploy confirmed. The second of the two BlackSky satellites that are on top of the large stack that you see there. So we've got the first two out. There are 57 more to go. So with that, we're going to take another break right now. We'll leave you with the animation, shows where we are in the coast phase, and we'll be back around T plus 1 hour and 32 minutes.
Oh, you can see the video just came back here of them floating away into space. To date now, we've sent 595 Starlink satellites into orbit. You can see on your screen there, the satellites are slowly separating from each other, and shortly they will deploy their solar arrays. Now, over the course of the next few days and weeks, these satellites will use their onboard ion thrusters to distance themselves from each other and enter their operational orbits.
Well, that brings our webcast to a close, and what a week it's been here at SpaceX. Just 4 days ago, we saw Crew Demo 2 successfully return home with NASA astronauts Doug Hurley and Bob Behnken. On Tuesday, Starship took flight at our South Texas location, and now we've capped it off with our 10th successful Starlink mission to date. As we watch the Starlinks drifting away, getting ready for their weekend, we'd like to thank you, our customer, Spaceflight, the Federal Aviation Administration for licensing the launch, and the 45th Space Wing and NASA Kennedy Space Center for their range support today.